seek you the more I find you the more I find you the more I seek you. I want to sit at your feet, drink from the cup in your hands, lay back against you and breathe, feel your heartbeat. This love is so deep, it's more than I can stand. I'm building your peace, it's overwhelming me. So overwhelming. The more I seek you, the more I find. The more I love you. I want to sit at your feet, drink from the cup in your hands, lay back against you and breathe, feel your heartbeat. This love is so deep, it's more than I can stand. I'm building your peace, it's overwhelming. The more I find you, Jesus. The more I find you, Lord. The more I love you. I want to sit at your feet, drink from the cup in your hands, lay back against your heartbeat. This love is so deep, it's more than I can stand. I'm melting your peace, it's overwhelming. I'm lost without you, and I'm desperate for you. This is my daily bread. This is the air I breathe. I'm desperate for you. And I'm lost without you. And I'm desperate for you. And I'm lost without you.
Father, For you said, Father, we lift up the name of your Son, Jesus. Lift him up. Jesus will draw all souls unto himself. Our aim and purpose and motion today is to lift up the mighty name of Jesus. Because it's only through and by the name of Jesus we are saved. We are free. We are healed. We are delivered, Father, in Jesus' name. Father, I thank you for keeping everyone under the sound of my voice, Father. Keeping them by the blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Forever keeping them, Father, and help them to remain kept in you, Father, in Jesus' name. But Father, help us to know that truly greater is the Holy Spirit who is indeed in us than in the devil who is in the world, Father. Help us to know and realize this truth, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I thank you, Father, for your love that you always have towards us. I just thank you for your presence right now with us, Father. I thank you for anointing every seat, Father. Even anointing the chairs right now, Father, so that the people who come in tomorrow, Father, that when they sit in the chairs, let them feel the fire presence of the Holy Spirit in convicting them of sin, righteousness, and judgment, Father. Just let your spirit continue to linger even when we leave this place, Father, for tomorrow, Father, to all those who sit in these seats, Father. Father, I ask you not to allow this room to be the same as we came in, but let your mighty presence just be in this room continually, Father, and draw souls to your Son, Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you, Father, right now that you sent this dispatch and sent forth the angels right now, Father, and gathering every hearer to hear this word, Father, in spirit, Father. I thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. I thank you, Father, for convicting those right now whom you told to come out on today's service, Father, but to allow that evil one to convince them otherwise, Father. Father, I ask you right now, send the Holy Spirit to convict them, Father, to let them know that the moment they hear your voice, don't harden that their heart, Father. Father, let them know that you take priority in their life and over their life, Father, in Jesus' name. Father, I just thank you, Father, and I give you all the praise and glory in Jesus' name. And we thank you, Father, what you're about to do today, Father, and setting captives free. Because, Father, you are still looking for those true worshipers. You're seeking, you're searching for those who worship you in spirit and in truth, because we know your word is true, Father. Father, give us a love for your word, a love to hear your word, Father. For we know that Jesus himself is the living word, Father. Father, give us that revelation of our very being and life in Jesus, Father, and also of who we are in him and he in us, Father. Father, help us to know this truth, Father. Father, we thank you for perfecting our trust, our faith only in you, Father, in Jesus' name. Father, don't allow neither one of us to leave your presence today in the same condition we came in, Father. Give us more of an in-depth revelation, Father, of who you are, understanding of your word, understanding of truth, Father. Help us to see that the most important is to look like Jesus from the inside, Father. And we thank you, Father, for cleansing us, Father, for ridding all evil, all darkness, in and everything that is not pleasing in your sight, Father, for ridding it out of us, Father. We thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. And we give you all the praise and glory, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you. Amen. You know, this morning I was seeing what the Lord had for me to minister on. And we're going to come from Isaiah, the 11th chapter, and I'm going to cover verses 1 through 5, and then we're going to jump to Isaiah, the 12th chapter. So as I was meditating, you know, I asked the Lord, what should I name it? Name this message, because I always like to have a name for the message. And so I went back upstairs, and my younger daughter came, and she began to share with me this cartoon that she watched last night on VeggieTales. And as she was sharing that cartoon, immediately I knew what the subject was. And we're going to talk about, what is your song? Dear heart, you are singing something. I know a lot of us, we don't have a natural talent to sing, but we sing. Because God himself doesn't look on a natural talent of singing. Singing comes from the heart. You make melody and tune from the heart. So the Lord said, what is your song? What are you singing about? What are you speaking about? What are you talking about? If you would examine your daily conversation, that would give you an idea of what your song is about. Is your song about the root of Jesse, Jesus Christ? What do you talk to your colleague about? What do you talk to your coworkers about? What is it? So again, when you examine your conversation, the Lord say, that is your song. So according to your song, it's gonna cause things to happen in this natural realm. It's gonna cause things to materialize in this natural realm. So according to your song, it's gonna produce either joy or happiness or sorrow or pain. It depends on what is your song. So in Isaiah, the 11th chapter, it says, and I read from the complete Jewish Bible, so it may read a little differently, but the spirit of understanding is still the same. Okay? So it said, but a branch will emerge from the trunk of Jesse. A shoot will grow from his roots. The spirit of Adonai, the Lord, will rest on him. The spirit of wisdom and understanding. The spirit of counsel and power. The spirit of knowledge and fearing Adonai. He will be inspired by fearing Adonai. He will not judge by what his eyes see or decide by what his ears hear. But he will judge the impoverished justly. He will decide fairly for the humble of the land. He will strike the land with a rod from his mouth and slay the wicked with a breath from his lips. Justice will be the belt around his waist. Faithfulness, the slash around his ears. So Jesus Christ, dear heart, he is the root of Jesse. He is the branch, dear heart, that bears fruit. Jesus Christ is the spirit of wisdom and understanding. Wisdom and understanding are found in our Lord Jesus Christ. Counsel and power and knowledge of fearing the Lord in Christ Jesus. So when you go to verse 12, it says, on that day he will say, and that day is this day. Because Jesus Christ has already made his arrival and departure from this realm. It is only through by Jesus Christ all things. And when the Lord say all things, he means all things are possible. Whatever the impossible is, it's possible with him. Sometimes I think we don't realize that all things is possible. So the Lord said, what is your song? What are you singing? Are you singing about your troubles? In this cartoon, this woman lost everything. Things just wasn't going the way she wanted them to go. So by her voicing her circumstances, that was her song. As she voiced those circumstances, which were her song, it produced more and more problems in this realm. More and more problems began to happen to her. Up until when she saw this little child. See, long time, we can learn a lot through little children, because the Lord said, unless we come as little child, we won't make it in. Why? Because a little child carries humility, humbleness. A little child is willing to be instructed by others. See, sometimes because of us being so far along in age, especially we have a little knowledge of scripture, we can't be told anything. You can always be told something. God can confound you by using a five-year-old little child and putting wisdom in that child. Why? Because that child is submissive and heart willing to be instructed here. So here this woman's song was concerning her problem. Everywhere she went, she talked about her problem. What the devil is doing to me. What demons, I hear it all the time. What demon spirit I see. What demon spirit is manifesting in my life. That's their song. Forgotten all about greater, greater, greater. Do you not believe greater is the Holy Spirit who's in you? Is he in you? Yes, he's in you because you are God's child. Greater is the Holy Spirit in you than any devil in the world. So we need to change our song. When this woman saw this child singing concerning its circumstance, because the child wanted their father to give them a certain toy, but the father did not. The father gave them a different toy. So the child didn't say, "Daddy, why didn't you give me the toy I wanted?" The child began to sing songs of thanksgiving. Thank you, Daddy, for giving me this, whatever this toy was. Made a song out of it, you see. And so this woman saw this little boy doing that. And by seeing this little child, the Holy Spirit convicted her. You need to change your song. Even though all these things had happened in her life, and she was singing the wrong song, so she started singing songs of thanksgiving. Instead of singing her circumstances, she began to sing the opposite of her circumstances. Now check this out, when she did that, things still got worse in the natural. It didn't get better, and not in the natural, but in the spirit, it was building up her faith in God. But she was persistent that she was no longer going to sing that tune of her circumstances. And she continued to sing the songs of thanksgiving. And when she did that, even though her circumstances were still the same, it changed her. So if Lord just said, our problem is we are looking for our circumstances to change first, when you should be looking for the change on the inside of you. And so this woman changed on the inside. When she changed the inside, she began to see her circumstances differently. And she started singing according to the word of God, according to thanksgiving. So the Lord said, on that day, which is now, because Jesus said, Doris, I have done it all. He has done it all. There's nothing else he's going to do. When you have done it all, everything that needs to be done, what do? You go take your seat and you rest. Jesus took his seat on the right-hand side of the Father. He rest. I have done it all. Here we are looking at our circumstance and singing the tune to our circumstance. And Jesus, at his position, see the rest in my child. Do you realize if I'm in you, I have done it all?
Yes.
Just receive of me. Change your songs. Change the tune to your song. Change the words to your song. Be thankful in all things. Not thankful for all things, but thankful in all things. He said, be thankful. And again, it will change you. Your circumstance may be the same. He said, it will change you. And if you continue to press on, be faithful, it will even change those circumstances. But you got to be faithful. You got to be faithful and change your song. He said, on that day when you say, I thank you, Adonai, you see, regardless of what our circumstances is, our song should be, I thank you, Lord. See, when I was young, it used to be a time I used to see elder people all the time humming to themselves, singing songs. They were so happy. And if you go into their home, people say, what do they have to sing about? Why are they so happy?
Yeah.
You see, but nowadays we got so much. We have lived in a nice house. We have air conditioner, nice cars to drive, and we're the most complaining people. But we have more than what our forefathers had. But we complain more. Why? Because we too busy looking at our circumstance and singing those tunes when our foreparents did not do that. They thanked the Lord. They thanked the Lord. Because of their circumstance, they thanked the Lord. He said, I thank you, Lord, because although you were angry at me, and there are, what I'm about to say, we all should always thank the Lord for this. I don't care what condition you're in, you think about what the scripture is telling us here. He said, I thank you, Lord, because although you were angry at me, it makes God angry when we disobey him. Spiritually, angry, he gets angry. It's like with our own children. You can't say you happy because they do things that's contrary. No, it makes you angry, but that anger is a love angry because you want what's best for them. He said, although you were angry at me, your anger is not turned away, and you are comforting me. Now, behold, again, regardless of what our circumstances is, we should sing this tune. Lord, thank you. Although you angry at me, you did not turn away from me, but instead you are comforting me. You are loving and caring for me, just like with our children. They know we're not happy when they do wrong things, but they know that we're not going to turn ourselves away from them. We will comfort them. Our Heavenly Father said, how much more will he do? Dear Lord, again, what is your song? What are you singing about? On your job, what are you singing about? You know, dear Lord, I want you to remember, the devil showed up to Jesus. He did. He boldly showed up where Jesus was. See those stones there? Turn them into bread. You know it's written in the scripture. All you have to do is speak the word and it turned to bread. Do it. Now the devil showed up to Jesus. Did Jesus go out and start talking about how much the devil came to him and trying to get him to rebel against his heavenly Father? No, Jesus didn't. He put the word to the devil. He spoke the word of God. The devil heard that conversation Jesus had with his heavenly Father when he spoke his word. And he did it three times. The devil said, okay, ain't nothing I can do. And he walked away. But I'm going to tell you, I'm learning. When the devil speak to you and you give that devil an ear, keep listening and keep responding, he ain't going to stop tormenting you. He ain't going to stop visiting you. He's going to come at you more and more. Why? Because you've given him space to do so. The devil don't even acknowledge his presence. You know how in the natural, an uninvited person just come and butt into your conversation. You don't even acknowledge their presence. Same way with the devil. Don't acknowledge his presence. If you, Lord said, if you entertain and acknowledge his presence, he's going to continue visiting you. And his visit ain't going to leave you feeling good, feeling condemned, tormented, tortured. So the Lord said, we pay more attention to the devil than we are him. The Lord said, I am a jealous God. How would it feel if you marry and your husband pay another woman more attention who's fretting with him than he's paying with you? So in other words, you keep entertaining the devil when he comes visiting you. You are actually fretting with the devil, the Lord say. So you just ignore him and talk to your heavenly Father out loud because he can't read your mind. Just begin to praise the Lord. Just begin to magnify him. Just begin to exalt him. Just begin to tell Jesus how great he is. And as the devil is listening, he's walking away, walking back away, walking back away. That's why the Lord said, when you submit to me, then you better resist the devil will flee from you. And horror at that, he runs away fast. But if you don't do that, and you keep acknowledging his presence like that, he's going to continue to come at you. Two, it says, see, God is my salvation. See, we got to learn how to love on the Lord, to love on him. Just tell him how great, how good he is. Sing that song of praise and adoration. He's a praise of adoration, song of adoration to him. God is my salvation. I am confident and unafraid. You see. For the Lord himself is my strength and my song. See, the Lord is our song. So what is your song? The Lord is our song. Our boastfulness should be about him. Not about ourselves. Not about our career. Not even about how much we say God is blessing us. No. Sometimes, y'all, we are so selfish. long God giving me what I want. Oh God, you are the greatest. Oh, I love you, I love you. But the moment he allowed the devil to stop it, like he did Job, your song will change. Oh Lord, Lord just said that. Our song will change. Long as he give me my fine car, my fine house, my fine job, money in the bank. Oh, I have such a lovely song that I'm singing to the Lord. Girl, don't you know God is good? Yes, he is. But the moment he take it away, he said, your song will change. What happened to God? Is he still not good? He's still good. How would it make you feel if your children do you like that? You have children. How does it make you feel your children do you like that? Long you give them all, everything they want. Oh, mom, you're the greatest mom. Thank you, mom. But the moment mom don't have to give them, mom coming to them for help, their song changes. That's not love. That's unstableness. That's double-mindedness. And that's when God said, you would get nothing from him. So we need to ask Lord, and even including myself, forgive us, forgive me for being double-minded. Because it's so easy, Lord, to thank you when things are going so well. So easy. But Lord, I want you to raise me up to the point that I don't have a dime. Don't have a penny. Car is breaking down. And I need money to get it fed. I want it to be so that I trust you that you will supply all my needs according to your riches and glory. Not by what's in my bank account. Right now, there are those who are listening to me got bank accounts full. Oh, how much they say they love the Lord with everything. God is so good. The moment God allows something happen, and they go to that bank and the money is gone, the Lord say, what is your song? Is your song going to change? Are you going to trust me? Praise your holy name, Jesus. 3 say, then you will joyfully draw water from the springs of salvation. See, the only way we'll joyfully draw water from the springs of salvation is that we must sing the song of thanksgiving and praise. We must boast on him. For somebody, he keep having me to say, he wants you to boast on him. There are many, I heard many women boast more on their husband than they do God. Oh, I got the finest man, I got a good husband. But you never heard them boast on God. I'm sorry, dear boy, I love my husband. I do. We've been married more than 30 years. But I have learned that the reason why we married is because of Jesus Christ. So if I'm going to boast on him, now I thank my husband for the goodness that he do. But boasting on him, no, I boast on him. Because I know that if he is not submitted to God the way he should, the same way that he showed love toward me, he will show unfaithfulness. But God can keep him. So if you're going to boast on someone, you boast on Jesus because he never changed. Your husband will change on you. Your wife will change on you. But Jesus said, I will never change. So I hear the Lord tell us he wants us to boast on him. We go to work, some of us talk more about, girl, no, my husband did X, Y, Z. Again, I thank God for my husband. But I'm going to say it like this, girl, I thank Jesus. Because if it weren't for Jesus working through my husband wouldn't be so faithful. I wouldn't be so faithful. I would thank Jesus for myself. Because by loving Jesus, he helped me to also be faithful to my spouse. You see, but I get so many calls where I hear women who have literally made their husbands their God. And when their God lead them, they are so distorted. They have given up hope. When our hope is in Christ Jesus. If you will put your trust in God for your husband, especially when he's not being a priest of the home. Now there are some of them that are a man of the home because they provide for the home, but they lack that priestly role. And what I'm saying is they will talk the talk, but they're not walking the talk. Well, you don't walk the talk, you lacking your priestly position in the home. Then when the Lord worked through the wife who is submitted to him, the husband who's not walking in his priestly position, that jealousy comes up, and that's Satan. Then you have a vow. But if that wife will continue to submit to Jesus, see, Jesus will teach you how to submit to your husband even when he is not in submissive to God. Jesus will teach you. He taught me. He told me many years ago, Terry, you're not the man of the house. He told me that. Yes, Lord. He said, you're doing too much. You're not the man of the house. Because if my husband was slow to do things that should be done, I jumped up and did it quickly. The Lord said, no, you stop that. You're not the man. You're placing yourself in his position. Then too, probably got so used to it that he willingly gave me that position. And then the Lord said, no, don't let him give you that position. The man said, well, how did I give my wife that position? Because when you don't do what you should do as the man's duty in the home, the wife does it. So you're giving her your position. So the wife has to say, no, I refuse that position. And that's what I said, I refuse that position. And again, the Holy Spirit will teach you. He will teach you. He will teach you. So three say, then you will joyfully draw water from the springs of salvation. See, we all have drawn water from the springs of salvation, but we're not happy. Why? Because we're singing the wrong song. We're too busy looking at our circumstances. Our husband not doing what he should do. Our wife not doing what they do. Our children. I'm telling you, dear heart, if you continue to keep your mind on your circumstances, your emotions, your affection, your very being is going to be like a yo-yo. Up and down, up and down, up and down. And the Lord said, you're unstable in everything that you do. You're unstable. And he ain't going to give you anything. Those are his words. I'm just paraphrasing it from how the King James Version say it. But he's not going to do anything. But we got to continue to submit to him. We as women, we see that there are more women who have a tendency to quickly come to God than men. And what we should do is pray for those men. Pray for the men in our family. The old men, the young men, pray for them. Don't take their position. Don't put yourself in their role. Say, well, you don't do it, so I'm going to do it. There's a way to do our thing. There's a way to do it. But we will intercede in prayer because that's a battle that they're going through because the enemy do not want that home to be established upon truth. Because he knows that there's power in unity when it comes down to husband and wife, then there's power in unity there. Oh, you're talking about a nuclear explosion for that home. But women must continue to intercede for their husband. Now, when it happens, the enemy will come at you more. And what I've learned over the years, praise the Lord. That means it's working. That means it's working. Don't give it to the devil lies to say, well, there's something wrong with me. The enemy's attacking me. And you look at your husband, he's sound asleep, seemed to be resting peacefully. And here you up, then all night, can't sleep because the enemy is attacking you. The enemy attacking you because you are interceding for your family. And it's like, if I could just get that woman, the way he said about me, if I could just get that woman out of the way, I got that home. Because the woman is the one who's interceding for that family. Or in some cases, the man. If I can just get that man out the way, I can get that family. Because the man is interceding. So the one who's actually interceding is going to experience more of an attack than the one who's not. Now the one who's not experiencing attack, Satan make them feel, oh, you all right. That's why you're not. You don't feel what your wife is going through. That's why you don't feel what your husband's going through, because you are all right. No, that's not true all the time. No. Especially if that man or woman know they're living a contrary life in Christ Jesus. See, I'm changing this because I've been through it. But the main way of overcoming this is keeping your mind and your affection and your boast on Jesus Christ. Watching the song that you sing, don't sing about your circumstance. Now, when I say sing, I ain't just talking about a tune here. It's what your daily speech is about, what your daily talk is about. Well, I just, again, the Lord said, right now, each one of you, examine your conversation on a daily basis. On a day, what are you talking about? Right now, I pray, Father, in Jesus' name, that everyone who hear me here, now, and also over the internet later, that when they go about talking, bring back to your memory, to their remembrance, what is your song? What are you singing? What are you talking about? What's your conversation? And when the Holy Spirit do that, you're like, oops, Jesus is not getting no glory out of this. I'm not glorifying him. Then you repent. The Lord say you're seeing no more. When other people come to you and their song is not according to the word of God, look, you got to tell them that this is your life, your spiritual life in Christ. You could be here just one second, and this second could be gone. So you need to say, look, I don't care to hear that. Stop. Stop. I don't want to hear that. It's not helping me. Spiritually, it's not helping me. Because when someone speaks, and they don't speak words of God, it have a tendency to drag you down. It drains you. And when you leave that presence, you leave that presence feeling miserable. But if you notice, you be around someone who's always talking the word of God, talking what Jesus taught, to tell you what, remind you what Jesus said. When you leave that person's presence, you're like, man, I feel revived. Whew, I feel good. That's why. Because faith only in God only comes as you hear the word of God. So if faith in God comes as you hear, unbelief and doubt come as you hear too. So you have to watch your friend, watch who you talk to. You know, they may say you acting funny or you think you're much better than they are. So, no, I'm definitely not. Because the same Jesus died for me, he died for you too. It's just that I just got to guard what I hear. I got to guard what comes in of me and what goes out of me. When the time comes where I need somebody, you ain't going to be around. Only Jesus. And if I live a life that was separated from him, far away from him, then he's far away from me. So no, I just got to guard what I hear, I got to guard what I say. You know, girl, we have to do that to people because the devil works through people. Now, we will do it to the devil when he up front just comes to us in a demonic form. You do that right quick. But he ain't come that way. He come that way through a beautiful human being, someone you trust, someone you respect and honor. But when they open their mouth, what comes out their mouth is deadly. It's poison. And that's when you jump back and say, oh, that's what happened to Peter. Lord rebuke Peter and say, you don't know what spirit you are of. There Peter was, precious Peter. Lord loved Peter. And as he opened his mouth and the devil came out the words, Peter thought he was saying something good, but it was contrary to the will of God. You think the Lord just say, now Peter, you shouldn't have said that. No, he rebuked them. You don't know what spirit you are of. And I guarantee you, when the Lord told Peter that, Peter was like, what spirit was that of? That happened to me one time, dear boy. The devil spoke to me. And I got rebuked later. And I thought about it, the Lord said, Terry, they right, that was not my spirit. I felt so bad. Forgive me. Thank God he forgave me. The Lord said, what is your song? What are you singing? His desire is for us to boast on him. Regardless of he give you the car that you've been wanting all your life, I'm not a car person, so I don't know the name brand car. You know, a lot of times people get a name brand car, they tell everybody, what's the name brand car, right?
Mercedes.
You know that tell everybody got that Mercedes. Everybody bragging on that Mercedes. A Mercedes compared to Jesus is trash. It's nothing. But you heard them boasting about Jesus, what Jesus has done for them. And what he is doing, they don't boast. They don't post on the Lord, but they'll boast about their Mercedes. They even boast about how much money they put into someone else's hair on their head. Girl, I paid $400, $200 for this hair. Don't it look good? Yeah, girl, you look good. Hair now. Don't even boast on Jesus like that. Somebody else's hair. I can see him, your hair. I'm sorry, y'all. I'm not going to rejoice with you. You come boast about somebody else's hair on your head. Now, if it's your hair, I'm going to be happy. Girl, I wish I had hair like that. That is beautiful. Thank God for giving you such beautiful hair. But it's not your hair. Don't cousin French King think she's going to boast with you or be happy with you, because I'm not. It's not your hair. No, I tell you, we need to think about our actions here. But you have God's children who does such things. And the Lord said he's jealous. Can you imagine how the Lord feels up there? He's looking down at us. My child, I don't really boast about me like that. Look what I've done for you. Look what I am doing. Do you not see my angels around you who's protecting them demons on who's behind them and preventing them from coming and grabbing you and just tearing you to bits and pieces? The Lord said, told me, demons desire to just grab us and just tear us, tear off an arm, tear off a leg, a head or whatever, just tear us up. That's what they desire to do. But the Lord, protection, don't allow them to do it. Every now and then, in countries that don't worship the Lord, you will hear that happening. The Lord said, that's what demons always desire to do, but he protects us. So just getting up in the morning, say, Lord, thank you this day for my day to breathe. Thank you for delivering me from the evil one. Thank you for protecting me, Father. Wherever you go, I'm driving down the street, Lord, I thank you, because I know, even though my eyes can't see, but in the spirit, there are accidental demons lined up, looking to see whose mind is not on you, so they could call an accident and kill a person. I thank you, Jesus, that you are not allowed to those demons to do it because of the angels who are protecting me. See, we have to keep our mind on Lord, boast on Lord, because when we boast on the Lord, that ties the devil's hand from attacking us. You know, again, we're so busy seeing things in the natural realm, that's what we believe. That's all it is to it, but it's not yours. He said, may his deeds known among people, declare how exalted is his name. He said, sing to the Lord. Just brag on him. When things not going right, just open mouth and sing a tune to the Lord. You know, that song is to the Lord. It's not to people. So people say, girl, because you can't sing. But this song ain't to you. This is to the Lord. And he's looking in my heart. He don't even hear the sound come from my mouth. He's looking for the sound from my heart. See, that's the devil trying to get you to hush up. Because the more you sing to the Lord, the devil's back bang. Back bang. So the Lord is telling us he wants us to sing to him. For he has triumphed. He has triumphed. Sing about his goodness. We don't have any goodness. We got sorrow, pain, sickness, and death. But he has goodness. So he says, sing of his goodness. As you sing of his goodness, it'll change you. It'll just make you a much happier person to even be around. You even found sinners that will look at you and say, you know what, I see joy all over your face. I like that joy. How do you get that joy? And that's an open door for you to boast and brag on Jesus to that sinner. And that sinner said, well, can I have the same? He said, sure. And you can lead him to Jesus Christ. But if you're singing about your circumstances, then when sinners look on you, they say, oh, that person don't think that I'm lying. They're going to keep their distance from you. You see. So the Lord says, sing to Adonai, for he has triumphed. This is being made known throughout the earth. He says, shout and sing for joy. You who live in Zion, for the Holy One of Israel is with you in his greatness. Do we believe that the Lord is with us in his greatness? That's why he said, all things are possible to him who believes, of course. You must believe. If you don't believe him, it'll never happen. Greatness is in you because of the Holy Spirit. So again, I hear the Lord say, he's a jealous God. He wants us to boast of one another. When things not going the way we want them to go, don't talk about it. Don't get on Facebook and tell people about it. Do you not know that's your reward? When I found it out that whatever I need of God, and I don't take it to God and wait on Him, but I go out and take other means, He said, that is my reward. I said, oh, no, I don't want that as my reward. He said, well, that will be your reward. Those faithful friends talking about you will be your reward. Because everybody on Facebook are not your friends. They're not your friends. So there's a lot of things you just don't tell no one about. You just sing a song of prayer. Get on Facebook and glorify Him. Just glorify His holy name. Just boast on Him. Tell them, your friend, girl, I met a man. Who, girl? What's his name? Jesus, that you heard him say, oh. Right then, you know that ain't right. And you need to remove your other friend. You need to remove that other friend now. Hey, you know, boast on Him. You know, God commissioned me about 3 years ago, because Riley's been acting on Facebook for a long time, but when we knew him, Riley, the Lord said, I want you to go on Facebook, Terry, spread my word. I said, yes, Lord, that's what I do. I get so many devils get mad with me. So many, but I still be obedient to the Lord. I'm not up there to tell you about my family. You know, I let you, I do have a family, do have a husband. I'm not up there to say how much, oh Lord, you forgive us. How much my husband loved me. Oh, I hear that all the time. I said, Lord, she's going to be so hurt when she found out her husband looking at another woman. You know, he didn't see me up there to boast about my husband, boast about my children. Every now and then I share my family because there's some who want to see my family. I said, okay, that's fine. But every time you turn around, send a post out about my husband. I'll tell you something, young ladies. I learned from my grandmother. You don't tell the young women everything about your husband. You think they have it for you. Girl, they will sit and try to steal love to see just how great he is. And these silly women say, honey, my husband was good last night. We grown up here, no children.
Yeah.
My husband was good in the bed. Girl, you better stop that because that woman gonna say, I'm gonna see how much good he is. As a matter of fact, my grandmama told me a story that it happened to one of her friends. That they were together, her and two more friends together. And the woman always boasted about how good her husband was in the bed. To the other woman, finally looked at my grandma and said, I'm gonna see how much good he is. And he slept with her husband. I don't think she ever found out. So there's just some things you don't be bragging about your husband. You can say, well, I know my husband, he won't do it. Is he a man? You better pray and thank God to keep him. Don't put your confidence direct in him and saying that he'll keep to himself. You better trust God that he keeps that man. Same thing with the woman. You just don't share everything with your girlfriends about your husband. When I was working, they didn't hear me say nothing about my husband. They talk about theirs all they want to. They didn't hear nothing on mine because I remember what my grandma was saying. And I knew my husband at that time, too, had not been delivered from the spirit of lust, too. That was many, many years ago now. Well, not now, many years ago. I said, no way. So you stop that. Same thing for you men who are listening. Bragging about your beautiful wife. Well, that friend of yours gonna see just how beautiful that wife is. Because I want to see for myself. And when it happens, just pray, blame yourself. So you have to use wisdom in everything. Even unmarried, there's some unmarried girls who have done that about their boyfriends to their girlfriend. Next thing you know, their boyfriend left them to be with the girlfriend. So you really have to use it. So if you're going to boast about somebody, but you don't mind them trying him, let it be Jesus.
Yes.
Let it be Jesus. He's all mine. You could, he's willing to be shared with many. He's open to all. Because you know he's going to be faithful to you, just like he's going to be faithful to them.
Amen.
Amen. So you just boast about the Lord. Amen. Praise his holy name. I thank you. Oops. Oh, no. Thank the Lord. Lord, we thank you and praise you. But that's strange. Amen. Now, the water leaked out here, y'all. But there's no water. Ain't that something? Amen. But Lord, we thank you in Jesus' name for the word you just brought. And I know that the Holy Spirit planted a seed in your heart of understanding. Your heart and mind was enlightened. So that's why it's very important to minister God's word, because you don't know what God would do if you don't first hear what he have done. Because faith and trust in what he have done only comes as you hear what he have done. It builds faith. So if you go to any service, if the word of God not coming forth, you will leave empty. Because faith in God only comes as you hear the word of God. And the Holy Spirit likes to be reminded of God's word so that he can perform his word. So what God wants to do now, he wants to set captives free. So all of y'all want prayer, just come forward. Right now, in Jesus' name, the time is up, Spirit Husband.
You're the name of
out. Come out.
All names.
Out. Come out. Out of her mind.
Worthy.
Come out of her will. Come out of her emotions. Come out of her body. Snakes,
my heart,
come out of her
sing.
Belly. Come out.
Outrage.
Out in Jesus' name. Out. Holy Ghost, fire. Holy Ghost, fire. Burn. Burn. Burn! Come out! Loose her! Come out of her mind! Come out of her will! Out of her emotions! Come out of her body! Holy Ghost, fire! Burn! Burn all evil, all darkness! Everything that is not of you! Everything that lurks in her mind! Out of her mind! Out of her mind! Out of her will! Out of her emotions! Out of her body! Out of her body! Out of her body! Out of her mind! Come out now! Come out! 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 Loose her! Loose her! Loose her! Loose her! Completely out of Peccalo! Pack it low, pack it low, come out. Loose her in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost, fire, purge, clean, burn by your mighty fire power in Jesus' name. Loose her and let her go. You have no legal right. Out, 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 out in Jesus' name. Out in Jesus' name. Out in Jesus' name. Completely out. Pack your load and go in the name of Jesus. For the blood of Jesus has forgiven her. The blood of Jesus has forgiven her and her ancestors. The blood of Jesus set her free. The blood of Jesus died and suffered for her. In Jesus' name, be free. Be free. Free. Free in your mind to serve the Lord in spirit and truth. Free in your will to serve the Lord in spirit and truth. Free in your body to serve the Lord in spirit and truth. Free in your emotions to serve the Lord in spirit and truth. Be free in Jesus' name. Be free. Be free in the name of Jesus, sister. Be free. Be free in Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name, be free. Thank you, Father. Father, here's your daughter here. Father, she pushed her way out because her desire is to serve you in spirit and truth. Search your heart. Search your mind. Search your will. Search your emotion. Search your body. Every illegal foreign object, come out in the name of Jesus. Come out of her mind, Spirit Husband. Come out of her will. Come out of her emotion. Come out of her body in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost, fire. Burn from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. Burn in Jesus' name. Burn in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Burn in Jesus' name. Burn in the name of Jesus. Come out of her body. Out. Out, out, out in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. Come out. Come out. Completely out. And completely out. Out. Come out. Come out of her body.
I'll pray.
Out of her body. Out of her body. Come out of her mind. Completely out of her mind. Come out of her will. Come out of her emotions now. Holy Ghost fire, continue to burn. Continue to flood, continue to consume, continue to sweep all darkness, all evil from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. Holy Ghost fire, ransack her mind, ransack her will, ransack her emotion, ransack her body. Drive out all spiritual poison completely out of her body now. Come out in the name of Jesus. Come out of her mind, loose her mind. Loose her will, loose her emotion, loose her body now in the mighty name of Jesus. Continue to consume all darkness, consume all evil, consume all darkness and evil in the name of Jesus. Purge her, all sicknesses come out of her body in Jesus' name. Spirit infirmity come out of her body in the name of Jesus. For the blood of Jesus has forgiven her, the blood of Jesus sets her free in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name be free. Be free to serve him in spirit and truth. Be free in your mind and your will. Be free in your emotions and your body to serve the Lord thy God. Be free, be free, be free in Jesus' name. Be free, Father. Revelate the heart to the normal be, Father, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for healing her body. Thank you, Father, for healing her situation, her circumstances, Father. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Let your blood flow through my body, Father. Driving out all sicknesses and darkness, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, restore her to health. Restore her as you made her, Father, in spirit and truth, Father. Restore her to the power of your soul with me, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, give her peace of mind. Peace of heart, we are, Father, in the most of Father, in Jesus' name. Set your angel around her. Where she go, Father? Lead and guide and protect her, Father, in Jesus' name.
Worthy of all my praise.
She is in the Lord. Who the Lord is in her, Father.
My heart will sing.
In the name of Jesus, be free.
I'll pray to the Son.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Let me bless you. I want to bless you. Father, here's your daughter. Father, bless her for being faithful. Faithful to you, Father. Listen to your voice. Open up doors for her, Father. Everlasting doors that the enemy cannot close, Father, in Jesus' name. She made a sacrifice, Father, to obey your voice, Father. Father, use her to your glory, bringing glory to Jesus, Father. Teach her her hands to fight in this spiritual battle, Father. Father, let the light in her shine brightly, Father. For those in her workplace, those in her home and around her, Father, may see you, Father, brightly shine through her, Father. Father, draw all people to yourself through her, Father, in Jesus' name.
Heal
her, Father, in Jesus' name. Anoint her, fill her with your Holy Ghost, Father. May her to overflow your spirit, Lord. Make a mighty, powerful church of the Lord. And bring glory to Jesus, Father, in Jesus' name. Father, I thank you for putting that shield of protection around her, Father. Wherever she may go, let her put a fire of fire. Wherever she goes, Father, in Jesus' name. And I thank you, Father, in Jesus' name, my daughter. You are glad in the mighty name. Devil, you have tormented her long enough in the mighty name of Jesus. You no longer come near her body, for she is anointed vessel of God Almighty. Come out of her mind. You've been there. You are in there. Come out. Ow, ow, ow. Holy Ghost, fire. Fire. Come out of her mind in Jesus' name. Out of her thoughts. Out of her will. Out of her emotions. Come out of her body. Ow. Snakes, come out. Ow, ow, in Jesus' name. Out in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire.
There is power.
Holy Ghost fire. Burn, burn in the name of Jesus. Burn everything that is not of you. From the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. Come out in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire. 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 Burn, 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 burn in Jesus' name. Burn in Jesus' name. Burn in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Burn in Jesus' name. Loose her and let her go. Burn not to torment her again. Spiritual or imagery. Let the fire of the Holy Ghost burn and consume all darkness, all evil from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name, continue to burn, Holy Ghost. Continue to burn, 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 burn. Don't leave no arrow compartment to touch your fall. By your mighty fire, power of the Holy Ghost, burn out all darkness and evil in Jesus' name. Courage, courage, consume all darkness, consume all evil. Consume the forces in Jesus' name. Consume the forces by your mighty fire in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Loose her and let her go. Let her go.
To break every chain.
Father, send your angels in the spirit.
Break every chain.
That's not of you, Father.
Break every chain.
Lord, my home right now, Father. Every spirit, every darkness, Father.
Break every chain.
Burn the very footsteps of darkness, evil. Burn every bed right now, Father. Between the sheets in the name of Jesus, let the fire of the Holy Ghost burn. Burn
break every chain.
Father, thank you for the fire of the Holy Ghost. Be
break
desired.
Every chain.
Let the fire of the Holy Ghost
burn. Break every chain.
In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus.
There is power.
In Jesus' name. Be free. 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 Free.
In the name of Jesus.
Free. Thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus.
There is power.
Father, we thank you for freeing your daughters today. We thank you, Father, in Jesus' name, for setting us free to serve you in spirit and in truth, Father. We thank you, Father, for raising us to be mighty.
Break every chain.
Your glory, Father, in the name of
break
Jesus.
Break every chain.
Father, anoint them, Father.
Break every chain.
Break
every chain.
Break every chain.
Break every chain.
Father, wherever they
break
go, Father, let the fire of the Holy Ghost consume all evil. Wherever they go, Father, in the mighty name of
break
Jesus, Father,
every
Father,
chain.
I thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. We praise you.
There is power.
Thank you, Jesus.
In the name.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory to Jesus.
Glory to Jesus. Glory to Jesus. Glory to Jesus.
There is power.
Yes, Father. Father, I ask you in the name of Jesus. Every spirit that
Jesus.
You are not of the Holy Spirit, you loose him. Come out of his mind. Come out of his
there
will. Come out of his emotion. Come out of his hearing now. In the name of Jesus. Loose him and let him go. Holy Ghost, fire, burn, burn from the crown of his head to the sole of his feet. Come out now.
There is power.
Out in Jesus' name. Loose your hold, for the Holy Ghost, pray that you are. Come out, out, loose him, loose him, loose him, loose him in Jesus' name. Loose him in Jesus' name. You pray that you are, for the blood of Jesus set you free. The blood of Jesus, I don't care, every single day. Witchcraft that you still get him, and you set the lens of the name of Jesus. And I cry the blood of Jesus against you, and I stop that scripture from you before, to detach him from you. In the name of Jesus, for the blood of Jesus has given him
break
his master. The blood of Jesus has set them free.
Break
in the name
chain.
Of Jesus, you free.
Break
be free to serve
chain.
The Lord in spirit and in truth.
Break every chain.
Be free in Jesus' name.
Break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain.
To loose him. High blood pressure. Go! In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name. You hearken to the command of God. Not his wife, but to the command of God. You can loose him. Loose him. Loose him. Out, out, out in Jesus' name. Out in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Glory to your holy name. Thank you.
There is power.
Glory to your holy name. Thank you.
In the name.
Father, we just thank you for your mercy and your grace, Lord. We you, thank you, Lord, for your presence today, Father. We thank you for being with us, Father, leading God. Father, I thank you, Father, for preparing the way for them to go back to their dwelling place, Father. Change, Father. Father, let others see what great work that you've done through them, Father, in Jesus' name. Father, we receive everything you've done today by faith in Jesus, by faith, Father. And we thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. We glorify you and magnify you in the name of Jesus. But right now, I turn the service over to Rod. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you.
Well, actually, I don't have anything to say except praise the Lord. Thank you for tuning in. We are probably running close on time. So, again, as always, stay tuned to the website for updates. Check the calendar. And thank you for tuning in. For those of you that are watching over the internet, feel free to submit an offering online if you'd like to. You know, we don't harp on offerings. We don't ask all the time. But if you're led to give, there's a donate button on the website. Feel free, and the Lord will bless you based on what you give, not what we ask you to give, but what you give. And so we give God all the glory, honor, and praise for today's service. This is a new location. We found out almost at the last minute that the previous location we had to vacate because of some renovations that they're going to do. For reuse in their facility. So we thank God that we were able to find this facility. It's used by two other churches in the area, and so we are able to use the facilities when they're not here. So we thank God for that. We thank God for each and every one of you that are here. It was a surprise to hear that we have guests all the way from Maryland, and so we thank you for making the trip down, especially on a holiday weekend. So we pray traveling mercies for you on the way back, because that area is always heavily traveled this time of the year. And so we don't take your coming lightly. We thank the Lord for it. And also for our first time visitor, I'm not going to embarrass her, but she knows who she is. So thanks for coming, and I'll make introductions afterwards. So that's it. Again, visit the website. Oh, before I forget, you saw Evangelist King using the anointing water. That's something that the Lord put in her heart to do a few weeks ago, to start making anointing water available for those who would like to obtain a bottle. You're not buying the anointing. What you're doing is you're making a donation into the ministry to help facilitate what goes on. It's $15. For a bottle of anointing water. Now, what's so special about the water? Nothing. Except the power of God. It's the that's why it's called the anointing water. The Apostle Paul used handkerchiefs. So we're using, in faith, by faith, water. She could have done the handkerchiefs, but she felt led to do water. And if you notice, there's a story in the Bible about the Pool of Siloam. So it's scriptural that there is a healing water, if you will. So go to the website. It's $15 a bottle for your donation. The bulk of your donation actually covers the shipping costs. And what little bit is left is actually put back into the ministry. And so you will be blessed by that if you choose to do so. So thank you for tuning in. And we say shalom to you who are watching. And thank you to those who are here. That concludes the service. For those of you that want to give here, you feel free to do so, and we bless you in Jesus' name. Shalom.